ओके ओके सो महादेव हर टू ऑल ऑफ यू. आई एम एन इंडियन एंड माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर रितेश वल्लभ भाई बोरीचांगर. प्रेजेंटली आई एम वर्किंग विथ नवसारी एग्रीकल्चर यूनिवर्सिटी एज नोडल ऑफिसर एंड एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर कॉलेज ऑफ फिशरीज साइंस नवसारी. एंड सिंस 2000 आई हैव बीन वर्किंग विथ वेरियस you know, government institute like state physics department, and then I had joined Anand Agriculture University as a scientist in Krishi Vigyan Kendra, then assistant professor of fisheries in different kind of scheme at AAU Anand, and since 2012 I have been working with Navsari Agriculture University as a associate professor and nodal officer. So today, I'm very thankful to Dr. Smith and his team. And today my topic on breeding of marine ornamental fishes. So most probably this lecture is last one, I think so. And let me congratulate to all the speakers. They very nicely presented. So they and they have covered all the aspect of ornamental fish related things. So this one is breeding of marine ornamental fish. So yeah, ornamental fish trade glimpse on particular these things. Ornamental fish share nearly 0.5% of total international fish trade. So it is not much, but 0.5% is mind it, and almost it's annual trade nearly 200 to 350 millions US dollar. The biggest exporter right now Southeast Asia, comprising 51% of export share. Out of this, Singapore is among the dominating as the top exporting country in the world with 20% share. And as you know, or as you heard about, the biggest importers are US, Japan, and European countries like Germany, Netherlands, and Italy. So nearly 1,500 ornamental species are traded during the last decades. The trade mainly depend on wild cage. This is big issues, huh? So look at this picture, and we pray to Almighty that God's creation is what man can create. Yeah, this is the big question, and God has Almighty has creation is very unique right now. And we could not reach up to the mark, and human being constructive part are nothing against their destructive part. So we are the destructive part of this planet, and that's why this COVID is come. So yeah, so these are the some techniques, wild catch technique, which is very harmful to environment, a destructive collection technique rather, we can say that. That not only affect the target fish, but are terribly dangerous to the ecosystem and reef habit. So this blasting and cyanide application and this kind of things is right now seen. One question arises in my mind. Is beauty valuable to ecosystem? So yeah. Because you can see that annually global trade, estimated annually global trade, nearly, marine life is nearly 20 to 25 millions, and coral species. Look at this figure, 12 million coral species, and other invertebrate, they are nearly 10 millions. So this, this figure is eye-opening figure. Yeah. That means that 19% marine organism are wild caught, and this is big issue. This wild caught from where we can this where we can get these things? So from coral reefs and adjacent areas, and very highly productive ecosystem from that we can quote these things. So yeah, earlier slide I have already show you that destructive collision techniques like cyanide dynamite or explosive are very terrible damage to ecosystem and reef habit. Okay, so what to do? Yeah, that means how you can save this thing? What to do to save the environment or ecosystem? So measure can be taken in order to reduce the environmental damage. So ultimately, we are looking for, you know, local government. So we are largely depend on the local government, that government policies and government implement, you know, government mechanization can save all these things. But it is not a responsible, only responsible that the government has to look after all these things. But community groups, they have to come forward like us. This we all are the fisheries fraternity community group, so we also taking care of these things. Then environmental organization like United Nations Environment Program and Marine Aquarium Council is there, have worked to achieve the integration and standardization of procedure to taking care of the marine ecosystem. They have said some you know, this MAC was established in 1996 and launched in late 2001. So they have some certain certification processes there. So they can taking care of this kind of measures. And ultimately, yeah, private sector like Tata and Reliance, they are doing this kind of things. So finally, we all are working for the aim to sustainable business. So the ornamental trade, how we can make this ornamental trade on sustainable business? This is our motto, I think so. So can we do sustainable? Yeah, this is a big question. So here we have to focus on research into aquaculture technology on particularly target species, say for example, clone fishes. So right now, you know, these destructive techniques have been affect the, you know, coral reefs habitat. Yeah, climate change also affect this this coral reefs. Right now, bleaching and this symbiote partner of clone fish, sea anemones also reduces. So ultimately, fishing pressure is going on right now. So this kind of thing affect the wild stocks. So we have to produce some aquaculture technology, and you all are the young scientists, so do something for our nation. So effectiveness of aquaculture facility must be carried out. And third one is fishing. So that's why these two things we can do, then fishing pressure on wild stocks are decreases. And ultimately, this provide income and employment in rural areas of developing countries. So yeah, this is a very big one. And right now, you know, Corona is going on. So current economic crisis is significantly drop in this business. So with this in mind, let us make today's lecture better. So yeah. First of all, glimpse of marine ornamental fishes with us. So yeah, marine ornamental numbers you can show in this slide. This fish species bred in captive condition. So nearly these 10 to 11 families I have here presented. Out of this, you know, Cygnetidae and Poma centridae are the having 12 species each, and demand trade demand is more about these things. So this is the glimpse of captive breeding of certain species. And next slide is on top 10 trade species of marine ornamental fish species worldwide. So here you can find four families: Poma centridae having clone fishes. So off-deaf species, Chrysiptera, species, amphiprion. So these are the cloned dam cells and all these things. Yeah, we have, you know, right now worldwide we have four largest family. Eight largest family having more than 400 species, fish species. So out of this, Labridae is one of these largest family having more than 400 fish species. Casey Jerram noted in his fish taxonomy book. So here one species is there, Labroids dimidiatus, with good attractive. Then Chitodontidae and Acanthuridae. Acanthuridae is well known for its attractive color and shapes. So we move toward the some certain families like Tretsere. Here it is Poma centridae, and the Poma centridae have Tretsere about 40 to 45% Tretsere. So you can imagine that what a demand of this kind of families having species. So almost they have wide diversity, 29 genera and 380 different species coming under this Poma centridae. And most attractive one is damsel fishes, and it is very common in aquarists. So they can live with anemone, sea anemones. So that's why its name is anemone fish. They symbiont with the anemones, sea anemones. So sea anemones tentacle touch, and they have some certain poison. So they kill the fish or predators except the clone fish. So this is a unique character. And parental care have been found in clone fish. They guard the eggs, and their eggs are predators. Egg predation have been found by horses and butterfly fish. So this is about the Poma centridae. Chitodontidae. Chitodontidae, worldwide genera, worldwide you can find 29 genera and nearly 113 species. And habitat, Chitodontidae particularly found in warm water and saline area like Red Sea to Pacific Ocean. They live in groups particularly for feeding, mating and all these things. And during breeding season, they make pairs. So it is also some unique character like this pair formation and all these things. They feed on omnivorous type of feeding. They feed on coral algae and some small benthic invertebrates. Yeah, monogamy. Then Acanthuridae. So worldwide nearly 5 genera having 78 species come under this family, and its common name is Sturgeon. Why this name is came? So yeah, caudal peduncle with one or more fixed and movable spine on both the side of the body. That's why Sturgeon. So this used to defend the themselves when threatened. So this kind of thing is having a key character and unique character. So sexual dichromatism is found. So it is somehow like this: male shows their color to the female, and once the male swim rapidly toward the surface, repeatedly, and where the female came during which they spawn. So this is a unique character of this Acanthuridae, and they are the herbivorous and grazes along the reefs. So it's a very attractive kind of things. Poma centridae, Poma canthidae. So Poma canthus, relatively larger, 40 to 45 centimeter, you can find over here. And this Poma centridae having 8 genera and 88 species. Territorial behavior, but not aggressive. Just found study revealed that some territorial behavior is found in Poma canthidae species. And it's a very unique character. Stout backward projecting spine on the lower edge of operculum. It's a unique character. And form, you can find that single dominant male and several female. So this kind of thing is found. Feed on sponge supplement with the some omnivorous kind of things. Yeah, Scorpionidae lionfish. So mostly venomous, and most popular aquaculture species, color red, brown or gray. They are the carnivorous type of feeding, crabs and small fishes, and they are the natural kind of things. And most attractive part of this Cygnetidae is seahorse. So 8 genera and 88 species have been identified in the Cygnetidae, and seahorse and pipefish belongs to this kind of things. And they have brood pouch, particularly seahorse have the brood pouch in male. And unique character is pectoral, anal and caudal fin absent. Look the photographs in your right hand side. And Schedule 1 of Wildlife Protection Act 1972, the sea was put in under the sea. They feed on the zooplankton, copepod, isopod and amphipods. Okay. So marine ornamental fish resource in India, so rather we can say that Lakshadweep and Andaman Nicobar have the coral reefs and coral islands, different kind of reefs found, atolls and all these things. So Lakshadweep having the most diversified ornamental fish resource in India. Nearly 300 species have been identified at Lakshadweep Island. And Andaman Nicobar, thereafter Andaman Nicobar is having 150 species, and Gulf of Mannar and Gulf of Kutch and Kerala thereafter. So because we are going to talk about the captive breeding, so this major breeding center in India have been identified by the or recognized or authorized by MPDA, nearly 212 major breeding centers around the countries. Amongst these, Kerala having the largest, covering 126 breeding centers, then Tamil Nadu, Madhya Pradesh, and ultimately Karnataka. So this is about the, and right now, Dr. Smith Linde is trying to establish ornamental major breeding centers. So hope for best that in future year we can get entry, our state entry will be very soon in this list. So captive, right now we are thinking for captive breeding. So some CMFRI have initiated some research on that particular ornamental fishes. So CMFRI resulted in development of hatcheries technology for nearly 21 species of marine ornamental fishes, and they have made some package of practices of different kind of fishes. So first one is clone fishes. So nearly 10 species of clone have been identify and package of practices have been developed by CMFRI. Next one is dam cell having 9 species in captive breeding of marine ornamental initiated by the CMFRI. And Doti Beak and Purple Fire Goby having each having one species. Okay, you can see it. The major aspect involved in ornamental fish cultures are, first one is collection and transportation of broodstock. This is a major issuing area from where we get the brooders, and if suppose brooders are there, then how to transport and all these things. So quarantine. So we all now in we all know about the quarantine because. This is COVID-19. So quarantine, it's required 3 to 4 weeks of quarantine. So, and clear, we can observe like that. If disease is present in that particular feces, then we can treat it. We can overcome this problem. So in case active brooders, broodstock. So there is no need of pair formation. I mean, there is no need because active brooders are there. They already made some pair. But when pair formation and broodstock development is not taking care of this, then undertaken in captive condition. For that, we have to make some tank-like structure and keep them, keep the whole fishes in that particular tank. So after 1 or 2 weeks or maybe 3 to 4 months, they get the pair. So next one is broodstock rearing setup and management, provision of substrate for egg deposition. The egg depositors are there, so they have certain kind of substrate and required. Feed formulation and broodstock feeding and feed scheduling. Feed is play a more significant role in that particular things because it is the most important part. Incubation of eggs and parental care, morphology of eggs, egg hatching techniques, larval rearing, nursery rearing, grow out culture, finally harvest of juvenile for trade, and ultimately packing and transportation. So allied section of substantial larval rearing. So this allied section having you know, different kind of live feed, because live feed section, you know, nutritional, its nutritional value is high and easy to culture, and size is small in size than mouth opening of larvae. So these three things are very unique in this live feed. So rather we can say that these are the living capsules, God's making living capsules for fish. So microalgae stock and mass culture, then zooplankton stock and mass culture comes under rotifers, copepods and cladocerans of marine fishes. And zooplankton harvesting and handling, Artemia cyst, Artemia plays a significant role in all bioenrichment. These are the allied sectors. So now, step for captive breeding. So main thing, four things, I have divided into four things. There's the maintenance of high water quality, because water quality will be degraded, then all goes under the mortality section. So I think Dr. Srivastav sir has taking care of this, and thanks to Dr. Srivastav sir. And provision of sustainable environment parameter, that is also play a significant role. Creating suitable condition for spawning. It is like that certain species have found, you know, some thermal soak require. Certain species have breeding techniques. So creating suitable condition for spawning and all these things. System for raising the larvae and juveniles. So now reproductive patterns we have observed in fishes like egg depositor, clone and dam cell, egg scatter, angel and butterfly, mouth brooder, cardinal, and live areas like seahorse and gobies. So these four things. Yeah, certain key points which we have identified like that. Okay, demersal spawner. A small number of large demersal eggs, which produce rise to fairly well-developed larvae. And these are some example, clone fishes and gobies and all these things, dotty eggs. And pelagic spawners. So pelagic spawners found a large number of small-sized pelagic eggs, small-sized eggs, but rise to small and poorly developed larvae. So angel fish is there, and certain pomacanthus species. So the third one is mouth breeder, incubating the egg clutch in their mouth and generally carried out by the male. So these kind of things are taken care by the male. And these are some example of that particular thing. And now we move toward the hatchery production of clone fish. So clone fish breeding, ultimately, first step toward things is collection and transportation of fish. It's most important part. Either you can collect from wild or purchase from the traders. So if wild coral reefs habitat you have to do scuba diving and collect the coral, collect the fish species, or maybe you can collect from the shore, or maybe, and kept them to quarantine for 3 to 4 weeks. Okay. Then pair formation is most important thing, because this family have unique character. So for that 500 liter tank, we kept this all the different kind, different size of fish kept in this 500 liter FRP tank. So taking care of this 5 to 8 species fishes with sea anemones, one sea anemone, so they can survive, and they can live, and they can make the pair formation easily. And some sea anemone is there, so light requires some for sea anemones. So 2,500 to 3,000 lux light should be there, provide to that particular tank. 15% body weight, 2 times a day you can feed them by live feed as well as wet feed. So Artemia nopalea is there, roti first are there, clam meat, shrimp meat, squid meat, having cholesterol and enrich feed you can give to them. Taking care of water quality parameter, and this is the most significant part. You can put a biological filter or sand filter to that particular tank. So temperature, maintain all these things, temperature in between 26 to 29 degrees centigrade, salinity in between 33 to 36 ppt. DO play most significant part. So 4.6 to 6.2, and pH. pH, seawater pH nearly 8.3 plus minus 2, something like that. So here 8.9 is too much. It is a typographical mistake. So nearly 8.5 you can maintain. Next one is sex. This one is sex change and pairing. So clone fish, having some pairing nature like this. They are the protandrous, male first and sequential hermaphrodite. So here you can find that in picture one, you can find one. Suppose female larger and dominant and monogamous, they can live up to the end part of the life. But if female die, largest male become female, and second largest juveniles, you can find over here in picture, second largest juvenile become active male and pair with newly transformed female. So this kind of thing, activity have been found in this clone fish. Then we come toward the broodstock development. So in broodstock development, pair form, suppose one formation of pair has been occur, then we have to transfer into separate glass aquaria tank. Glass aquaria, or maybe in a FRP tank or like that. So they can feed with two types of feed: a green mussel, shrimp, clam, fish egg, and enriched with vitamin and minerals. Highly means cholesterol feeding, or high means proteinous feeding can develop and increase spawning. Live feed, Rotipus and Artemia. So Rotipus at the rate of 800 to 1000 numbers per ml, you can feed them. And nopalea stage, Artemia nopalea, 200 to 400 number per ml, we can feed to this broodstock and maintain it. Yeah, water exchange and all these parameters, taking care of this during these kind of things. Okay, then I earlier told you that the water quality parameter, so for that, seawater need to be filtered through sand filter. So here you can see the sand filter. Yeah, water exchange once a week, 25% water exchange need to be done once a week. And this kind temperature, DO, and all the pH parameter, we have to maintain in optimum level. Okay, so now require some substrata for egg deposition. The egg depositor requires some substrata. So for that, rough surface substrata near to the host, and the clone fish host is the sea anemone. So near to host, you have to keep टाइल्स, अर्थन पॉट्स, सेल ऑफ ऑयस्टर, पीवीसी पाइप्स. सो दीस आर द सबस्ट्रेटा प्रोवाइड टू स्पॉनर्स. ओके, सो ब्रीडिंग एंड स्पॉनिंग. सो नाउ ऑल द फेवरेबल कंडीशन हैव बीन प्रोवाइड बाय अस, देन मेल सिलेक्ट सुटेबल साइट नियर टू सी एनीवन फॉर लेइंग eggs and clear debris with mouth. And when this kind of activity done by female also, then time is come to spawning. So spawning occur during 5 to 15 hours, huh? So daytime spawning occur. And fecundity, you can find the fecundity nearly 7,000 to 24,000 eggs per year, and some after 12 to 15 day interval you can find 300 to 1,000 eggs. So this kind of things have been noticed in clone fish. Egg shape most probably capsule type egg shape, and egg range you can find the length in between 1.9 to 2.9 mm and width 0.8 to 1.1 mm. So now parental care. This parental care is a unique character of this species. So a parent allowed to remain in hatching tank till hatching. So this, yeah. Because why? You can find pictures in both of the corner of the slide. Fanning and faltering pectoral fin to reduce egg mortality. They can provide circulation of water and provide oxygen, and remove dead eggs and dust on egg with mouth. So this kind of things activity created by male. So males share about 75% of share. So parental care has been taken by male. So I have taken two example, one or two species example, Amphiprion ocellaris. In this kind of in this species, the spawning time you can find during early morning hours, and frequency of spawning range from 12 to 15 days. So I would like to tell you that this clone fish have round ear breeders, but during very cold condition they can stop the breeding. They can stop the spawning. In favorable condition, they can do spawning round the year. The clutch size per spawning range from 300 to 1,000 eggs, and hatching was on evening of the 8th day of incubation. So it will take 8 days to spawn. The newly hatched larva measured nearly 3.2 to 4 mm in length, and larva culture protocol has been start from 16 to 17 days of hatching. So rather we can say that the metamorphism of juvenile stone after 16 to 17 days. So next one is Amphiprion percula. This spawning time also you can find here, this daytime in between 6 to 3 p.m. and the spawning inter range also found 14 to 18 days. The egg clutch size per spawning range from it means one clutch having 100 to 500 eggs, huh? Nearly. The hatching might be seen during evening time of 8th day of incubation, and length of newly hatched larva in between 1.9 to 2 mm size. During the 19 to 20 day of hatching, the larva metamorphosis into juvenile. Metamorphosis means all the stages have been covered. After that, juvenile maybe look like an adult. So that is the things. So from egg to juvenile stages belongs to metamorphosis. After that, juvenile look like an adult. So these two species can give more idea about the clone fish. So now we move toward the egg morphology. So here you can find that the newly spawned egg color on first day was observed light orange, and on second day color changed to bright orange. So capsule size eggs you can find in picture, and third day you can find embryo development like these things, this color, bright orange color turn into the black one. So it is clearly visible in picture. From 4 to 6 day, this color become very dark, and eye developing stage is there. So in between this stage, you can find eye develop, and clearly visible that big one eyes, big eyes you clearly visit, clearly seen in this photo, 4, 5, 6 photographs, 4, 5, 6 days of photographs. On 7th and 8th days, egg became silvery and glowing eye of larvae. So you can easily identify that in capsule. You can look at this picture. In capsule, you can find the two big eye with you know, silvery and glowing eye of larvae. So on 7 to 8 days of this kind of thing. So now for hatching, expected day of hatching, 2 hours before sunset, because during after sunset they can start hatching. So expected day of hatching, 2 hours before sunset, the eggs along with substratum transfer from parental cage to hatching tank. So hatching tank must be maybe 100 liter of FRP tank or glass, whatever. So most probably FRP tank, we kept this substrata and you know, eggs into hatching tank. So three types of larval rearing tanks or technology. Parental tank method, we can keep these eggs in parental tank. So we must remove the parents from that particular tank. Transferring of egg to hatching tank and subsequent larval rearing. And third one is transfer of larva to larval rearing tank. So here we can talk about the live feed, and you can find some picture. So yeah, live feed based on the larval mouth. So most significant part is that in clownfish, particularly 80 to 123 micron opening of mouth part. I would like to share you some information that if suppose you are giving larger you know, larger size live feed to that particular hatchling, then they could not survive. They are starved, and mortality will be started within short of period. So this is very significant. This is very significant part of these things. And yeah, from first to fifth day, in between rotifer branchina species, we can provide, because nearly 100 micron feed, we can, this is called microalgae, so we can provide for better survival rate. From 5th to 15 days, we can provide the newly hatched artemia plus rotifers plus mixed culture of algae, so they can get more survival. And yeah, and from 15 to 17 days, now we move toward the you know, wet feed, like we can start larvae feed on shrimp and fish meat. You can find over here shrimp and fish meat, mussels meat, clam meat, and formulated diet. So this kind of larval feed is play a very significant role. Then we come toward the light intensity. So in particularly in clownfish, if you could not provide the proper light intensity, then there will be a chances of head butting syndrome during larval rearing. Due to immature development of the retina, subsequent hitting of larval head, we have to provide some side of the tank. They are moving toward the side of the tank. So that's why all four side of tank cover with a black cloth or painted black to avoid the reflection of light. And second is low intensity light by hanging two numbers of 60 watt bulb at height of 15 to 20 centimeter for 24 hours. That we can do in between 0 days to 20 days. Okay. Then we move toward the juvenile rearing. So on the 19 to 20 day of post-hatching, larvae become juvenile and shifting from pelagic to epibenthic stage and look like a miniature of adult phase. That means metamorphosis will be over and it is look like an adult. So in that case, we can stock this juvenile 19 to 100 numbers per sea anemone. So keep sea anemone in this juvenile tank, larval rearing tank, and suppose a tank size nearly 250 to 1000 liter. We can put biological filter, so we can maintain all the we can do siphoning and all these things. This kind of practice will taking care of all the water parameter. Size of juvenile between 8 to 10 mm, and yeah, we can stock stocking density we can reduce up to 30 to 50 numbers per sea anemone in 100 liter tanks. So they can transfer to this 100 liter tank if suppose, yeah, we can keep in 250 liter also with a biological filter, seawater until marketing. So keep them up to the marketing level. Then most significant part is the juvenile feeding. So earlier we have already seen in previous slide that nearly 19 to 20 day of post-larvae larvae become juvenile and shift from that particular thing. So what will happen? Muscles meet, you can find over here, muscles meet, prawn muscles, fish eggs, mincemeat of trash feces, and live feed as Artemia rotifers, vitamins, minerals, and algal powders you can provide to juvenile feed at the rate of 15 to 20% body weight. Then transportation and packing also play significant role. Now we move toward the dam cell hatchery production of dam cell fish. Yeah, so same, I think some protocol has been found same as in clone fish. So this slide, I'm going toward the pair formation. Yeah, for pair formation, 1000 liter you know tank, you keep all the all the fishes in particular this kind of things. Taking care of this 10 fishes of different size group plus dead coral you can put inside the tank. Yeah, light intensity 12 hours, 7 to morning, 7 to evening, 7, 12 hours light with 600 to 900 lux light should be provided to pair formation tank, that particular tank. And 12 hours from evening 7 to morning 7 dark should be kept. So 15% body weight 2 times per day. Same things over find over here, weight feed and live feed you can give. So pair formation maybe between 2 to 3 months. So now this broodstock development and maintenance. So pair form transfer into the separate glass and aquarium aquaria tank. Fed them with live feed and wet feed. In wet feed, they can prepare green mussels, shrimp, clam, fish egg, and in meat enriched with the vitamin and minerals. And yeah, water quality parameter also taking care of this by sea water needed to be filtered through sand filter and all these things. Here you can find some substrata. Substrata for egg deposition, here demersal eggs are egg depositor. So we can provide substrata by putting some pipes and some dead coral and all these things. So you can find some fecundity nearly breeding and spawning. Under this category, you can find some fecundities between 1500 to 2500 eggs per day in some interval. So 10 to 15 days interval like this. Here you can find some eggs have this oval and transparent. And egg range, you can find length between 1.2 to 1.4 mm and width is nearly 0.6 to 0.7 mm. And hatching part, during morning hours, you can find some initiate hatching activity. And hatchlings length between 2 to 2.5 mm on third days. Okay. And larval rearing, you can find some substrata with egg clutch transferred to the larval rearing 500 liter tank containing seawater enriched with the microalgae on evening of third day after spawning. So after third day of spawning, you can transfer this egg clutch to larval rearing tank. Gentle air flow near the clutch. So this will keep them oxygenated. Egg out at the evening of fourth day. So ultimately, after 24 hours, you can find some hatch out. Larval feeding. So here also mentioned that larval mouth nearly 35 to 40 micron. So plankton and small microplankton and you know, N. salina, 10 to 20 number per ml, you can feed them up to the 20th day of DPH, day of post-hatching. Particularly copepod, this species likes the copepods. So copepod, nuclea, sagitta, mysis, ostracod, and certain juyas, they prefer to eat this species. Later, we can feed with Artemia nuclei at the rate of 3 to 5 numbers per ml. And from 25 to 30 days, where the size you will find 20 to 21 mm. This look like parents. So up to 24 after completion of metamorphosis, you can find some 20 to 21 mm size of larvae. It's a marketable size because after that, its marketable size can get within 5 months of rearing, and very low survival. I think the survival rate is 30 to 40% survival rate you can find. Larval development of dam cell. So you can find some picture in that particular thing. So it is, you know, last slide you can find this. It look like an adult. Now, H3 production of cardinal fish. So cardinal fish breeding also same as we have covered in previous slide. So this kind of thing. Pair formation. So here you can keep all the fish in 1000 liter tank, circular tank with 10 fishes of different size group plus dead coral. So you can find over here dead coral is required as a substrate. And wet feed and live feed you can provide to the fish. Pair formation period you can find after 3 to 4 week. That means it will take 1.5 months to get the pair. And nearly size of that particular pair, male and female, is between 5 to 7 centimeter. So broodstock development and maintenance, pair form transfer into the separate tank of 500 liter tank. They can feed with wet feed. Here you can find wet feed and live feed. Water quality parameter can be obtained very well in that particular tank by using biological filter siphoning and on 25% water exchange per week. Substrata, so demersal egg depositor, same substrata required. Now our last part of hatchery production is dotty bag. So I have covered 4 fishes in this presentation. hatchery production of dhoti bake. Here you can find collection and transportation of fish. You can purchase or you can get from wild. Here rather we have to follow the we have to rely on purchase and quarantine for 3 to 4 weeks. Yeah, pair formation. But here we can use 5,000 liter cement tank. And substratum provided by dead coral. 50 numbers of fish can stock with each dead coral. 5% body weight, 2 times a day you can feed the weight and live feed. And after 4 months, male and female fish were distinguished after 4 to 4.5 months. So breeding and spawning, here one unique character you can find, that courtship behavior of male exhibiting fin erection, vibrant color, chasing the female, swimming motions, and finally extension of inner dorsal and pelvic fin, and also show the front of female for attraction. So this kind of activity have been found in dhoti bake fish. Spawning time, spawning period in between 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. is daytime. So this time what happened, male enters the female to the nest side. They invite female near the nest side. And eggs have nearly spherical ball type on the substratum. And you know, some natural breeding take place after 1 year of rearing. So here require induced breeding was tried with, we can try it with a selective pair size range between 6.3 to 7.2 centimeter and 4.8 to 5.6 centimeter. So CMFRI scientists has made on lots on this particular fish species. So they have tried lot of things to do induced breeding. Egg diameter, naturally spawned, if naturally spawned, spawning may be done. 2 centimeter egg clutch is found, this diameter or maybe, so nearly clutch, one clutch having 1,000 to 1,200 numbers of eggs. In induced spawning, you can find 1.8 centimeter egg diameter, and you can find 700 to 900, some typographical mistake is there. 700 to 900 eggs numbers per clutch. So parental care, here you can find fanning frequency in both the pair, male and female. So counterparties also play a significant role. Mostly male fish guard and protect egg unit until, excuse me, please. Excuse me. Fanning frequencies in both the pair you can find. You can find in picture also. Mostly male fish guard and protect egg until the hatch. So until the hatch, we have to keep the male or and female. So parental care is, and egg morphology. So first day milky white in color, encased in flexible transparent spherical capsule surrounded by several threads. So something unique character, several threads have been found to make clutch, means cluster of like. Second and day, third day, embryo developed on black, and on fourth day it is also look like a silver color and indication of hatching. So indication of hatching, we can give like a silver color eggs will that indicate that hatching will be taken. So normally occur on night, fourth day night. In natural spawning, may good result, 90 to 95% hatch out, and induced spawning you can find 70 to 75% hatch out. And larval rearing, just larval size between 3.5 to 3.8 mm. So larvae feeding. So mouth size here also notice that larvae's mouth size is bigger than other. So 100 to 120 micron larvae mouth size. So feed microalgae as well as rotifers, nearly 100 micron size for that particular branchiness of pelicatalis. We can get wild plankton, collect the wild plankton and give it to the particular larval rearing thing. After 15 days, algal enrich Artemia nauplii, we can give algal enrich with certain vitamins and all these things, and Artemia nauplii. And stocking density should be maintained 15 to 20 number per means. This Artemia nauplii should be given to 15 to 20 number per ml. So this is about ornamental marine ornamental fish breeding. I have covered this four pieces for the marine breeding ornamental fish. So over to I'm very thankful to Honorable Vice Chancellor Dr. N. H. Kelavala sir, Kamdhenu University, Dr. Patil sir, Dr. Our Director of Extension, Dr. Smith sir.
Vatalia.
And Dr. Vatalia sir. Sorry, I'm very extremely sorry. So Dr. Vatalia sir and my colleagues, Dr. Smith sir, Dr. Srivastav and his team. So thank you very much for giving me this kind of opportunity. On behalf of College of Physics, Navsari Agricultural University, I express my gratitude towards the Kamdhenu University. And I'm also thankful to my College of Fisheries, Navsari Agricultural University family, because within short time they can prepare a very nice presentation. I have not made this kind of presentation. So Dr. Mihil, Dr. Vada, Dr. Vanja, and Dr. Solanki, Sital have made this presentation very nicely. So overall, in nutshell, I am very thankful to all of you. And please, over to
Sita. For your wonderful presentation, you have covered each and every aspect of marine fisheries. Really, marine fisheries segment and sector is an unexplored sector and has a huge potential in ornamental entrepreneurship development. Now, participant session is open for discussion. If anyone is having any question, please unmute yourself, ask the question. Sir, one of the participant has asked the question, in India, is there is any certification or verification system available or launched by government institute to reserve and preserve sustainable wild catch and regulate better marine ornamental trade?
I have no information regarding this question, so I'm not able to answer this question. Okay, maybe CMFRI, because I forget about the Scatophagus argus and pulseport. These two fish also belongs to ornamental brachiosauro fishes. So these two technology have been developed by SIBA also. So I forget this kind of thing, but I think government of India has regulated some in Ministry of Fisheries, Dairy and Veterinary, have certain rules and regulations, and certain guidelines have been made for this kind of things. And MPDA play also important role to this kind of taking care of this kind of activity. Okay. Apart from this, I don't know about this.
Okay. Anyone having any question? Krishnan sir, how was the presentation, sir?
Oh, it was very nice. We got quite good updates on marine ornaments, and that is a very important and a growing field. And Professor Gauri Changar had given a very exhaustive and, you know, very in-depth perspective of this subsector. Thank you very much, sir. It was really enlightening to hear your
thank you, sir,
and very educative. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your kind remarks.
Thank you very much, sir. Dear participants, there is one announcement from us. Today all our technical sessions are over, and tomorrow from morning at 11 hours we are having one online examination, and after that in afternoon hours we are having the validatory function for this MOOC course. So all in that MOOC validatory function, all participants will get their certificate one by one. So this is my request that you just go through examination. It is a basic kind of examination. Since from last 4 days, whatever the expert, on basis of that only we have we will conduct the examination. So thank you once again all. Thank you Gauri Changar sir for accepting our invitation.
Thank you.
So it is really a good your lecture session. Thank you one and all. So for thank today you. Our meeting, we are closing our meeting, and all the details regarding examinations and all that we will share on your personal email as well as our group. Thank you one and all. Thank you very much.
Thank you.